Today is one of those days when I feel happy. One of those days when I raise my hand to heaven and say, praise the Lord. Today is one of those days. And tell you why. As you know, ladies and gentlemen, for the past 3 years, I always stood up here and I blessed everyone, even all my colleagues. And I was the only Democratic senator that voted against the whole bill because of the Dream Act. For the past 3 years, and I asked all my colleagues, join me, vote against the Dream Act. Vote against the budget because of the Dream Act. They all believe all the promises that was given to them with cocoa butter and whatever, and they never followed me. I was the only one. But today everything changed. Today I'm proudly voting yes. And I'll tell you why I'm proudly voting yes. Because the governor of the state of New York, the Honorable Andrew Cuomo, and the leaders of this chamber, the Honorable Dean Skelos and the Honorable Jeff Klein, has done an excellent job in protecting every single student in public school. Everyone. Senator Holman just said, charter school are public school. And they are protecting every single student, especially the black and Hispanic children in my district. And that's why I'm so happy today. I'm happy, Mr. Mayor, Mr. President, because Mayor Bill de Blasio will be able to get the money he wanted for UPK. I'm happy because parents of children in New York City will see and have the opportunity to give an early childhood education to their loved one. Because our governor, I'm praising the governor today.
Where's the cocoa butter?
To praise the governor today. After 3 years, I'm praising the governor today, and I'm praising Jeff Klein, and I'm praising Dean Skelos. And I want to repeat that as many times as I could today. Because the governor and the leaders of this chamber found money to establish UPK without increasing taxes. I'm happy, Mr. President, because black and Hispanic children in charter school in New York City no longer have to be afraid of losing their God-sent opportunity. Charter schools are a God-sent blessing to black and Hispanic children in my district and in poor districts. We keep fighting every year, fighting to protect children, to protect the minorities. And when the minority got a good opportunity, we want to deny those opportunities. That's pure hypocrisy. Oh, everybody come here. Everybody come and make their business fighting this case for the poor black and Hispanic children. Everybody come. And everybody come here asking for money because black and Hispanic children are being left behind. And now when we have an opportunity to help black and Hispanic children, now they want to take that away. You should know that I was one of the initial proponents of charter school. Reverend Forflake from Queens, Reverend Wyatt T. Walker from Manhattan, and myself from the Bronx, the three of us together, we fought for charter school, and we established the first charter school in Harlem, Canaan Charter School. And I was the only, I was one of the only two Democratic senators, one of the only two Democratic senators that voted to increase the number of charter schools from 200 to 460. Only two senators, Democrats, voted for that. Senator Craig Johnson and myself. The rest of the Democratic senators voted against to increase charter school. And I keep saying, Mr. President and ladies and gentlemen, charter schools are mainly, are located in minority neighborhoods, in black and Hispanic neighborhoods. 90% of those students are black and Hispanic. Charter school is a blessing. And you could see there are 50,000 waiting children, and there are mother and father waiting to see their kids, their children go in. Somebody might say, and I heard that before, oh, but charter school is only for the lucky one because it's by lottery. It's by lottery, so not everyone has the opportunity. Well, hello. What about housing? I created, ladies and gentlemen, I created Reverend Diaz Plaza. I created Reverend Diaz Plaza, a building with 50 units for 50 families, low income. We had 3,000 applications for that for 50 apartments. We got 3,000 applications. The line was all the way around the block for Reverend Diaz Plaza. 50 apartments, and we got 3,000 applications. And then I created Reverend Diaz apartment for 97 apartments. And I got close to 4,000 applications. So what would I say? Oh, because everyone cannot get an apartment, we should not do it, and we should stop creating low-income houses for the community because it's a lottery, and because not everyone will be able to get an apartment, we should stop? No, on the contrary. We should continue fighting. We should continue creating, we should continue building low-income family, even though, ladies and gentlemen, not everyone will be able to benefit. So that's the case here with charter school. It's a lottery. Not everyone will be able to benefit. But ladies and gentlemen, hey, let's save whatever we can. Stop this nonsense of trying to kill black and Hispanic children in our, especially, forget about the rest of you, in my district. I got 21 charter schools in my district. I want more. Give me all those charter schools in my district. Let all the black and Hispanic children in my district benefit from this. The old children for God, black and white, brown and black and yellow. The old children of God. Ladies and gentlemen, that's why I'm happy today. And I praise the governor. Governor, listen to me, I'm praising you today. And I'm praising Jeff Klein. Jeff, I'm praising you today. Thank you very much. And you, Senator Skelos, I'm praising you today, Senator Skelos. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and Mr. President. Let me see if I have something to say here. You should know what you should know. And today, Mr. President, you should know that I'm voting yes, and that I am Senator Reverend Diaz, and this is what you should know. Thank you very much.